Let's dive into the memory architecture of JS. Hi, I'm Rohan, and this video is part of a series of videos where we are exploring how JS manages its memory in depth. So, let's get to it. Now that we understand the different data types, let's discuss the memory architecture of a typical JavaScript engine, though we will focus on V8 specifically. Broadly speaking, the memory is divided into two segments, the stack memory and heap memory. And if we zoom into the memory heap, then we find out that it is further divided into different segments. Those are new space, old space, large object space, code space, and three segments called cell space, property cell space, and map space. Let's look at each of these segments in detail. As discussed, the heap is divided into various spaces such as new space, old space, large object space, etc. But what about the space itself? What exactly is their layout? Each one of the space is divided into pages and each one of the page is divided into objects. In other words, when an object is created, it is inside one of these pages, which is inside a space and which is inside a heap. So, whenever we need to allocate an object, it looks for a free slot in one of the pages. If it is found, then that slot is allocated to the object and its corresponding reference is updated respectively. If no slot is found, then a new page is created and the object is allocated there. On the other hand, each garbage collection cycle frees up memory chunks all over the heap space. And if an entire page is freed up, then that page is removed from the space. By the way, V8 keeps track of these free memory chunks using a data structure called free list. So, to summarize, we discussed memory architecture and how heap spaces are organized and managed. I also want to discuss stack and heap memories and what roles they play. So, we will discuss these in the next videos. Thank you for your time. Have a nice day. Namaskar.